So hey, this is Shake from Fat Cat, and I'm doing. I have a phone call from a gentleman who saw a video that I did on MCS, and he made a comment about his observations. And so he wants. So please tell us your name and do whatever you want to share. I'm happy to listen.
So my name is Max, and I saw the Fat Cat Motorsport thread on the M3 forums about 2 years ago, and started playing with the spreadsheet. And around that time, I still had my old car, which had airbags. And I noticed the one thing mentioned about like flat ride in general was that the front would bounce and the back of the seat would hit the back of your head.
Mm.
And with the airbags, because I didn't know how to set, I always noticed that the air pressure in the bags were not the same.
Mm-hmm.
And I always thought that that made a somewhat of a difference in spring rates and kind of affected how the car reacted,
mm-hmm.
but I didn't know specifically how to adjust that.
Right.
And like exactly what it did, because the obviously higher PSI meant it was stiffer, lower PSI meant it was lower,
mm-hmm.
but in terms of what I needed
mm.
to set up the car, I didn't know what to do, so I kind of just was stuck with what it was.
Mm-hmm.
But it was on that same time where I blew my motor, so I was getting, I got a whole new M3, and I didn't really want to deal with air suspension, running the line, adding a tank and kind of moving everything, so I got mm-hmm. regular suspension,
mm-hmm.
I guess coilovers,
mm-hmm.
and I got coilovers with a 12K, 16K kind of variation,
mm-hmm.
and I've had the similar coilovers before, but I noticed, I never noticed it before because I didn't drive it as hard, I guess,
mm-hmm.
on the bags, but the issue I was having was the front end was jumping.
Uh-huh.
Out of certain corners or into certain bumps, the rear would stay flat, but the front would just bounce off to a point where when I drove it really hard in the mountains, I noticed coming into a turn, it would bounce off, and then you would hear the front tire skid right before you're entering the turn. It was
oops.
Terrifying.
Bad. Right.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then with the coilovers, it was definitely better. It was much more controlled, but it was still... When I just started thinking about it after reading the forum, I started paying more attention. I just started noticing that even with the 12K, 16K, the front had a slight gap, like a bump. And like, I started thinking, how can I do this? Because based on the spreadsheet,
mm-hmm.
I would need to go to like 24K in the rear, and I was 24, 26K. And
or soft in the front.
So I actually ended up getting a pair of 9K springs to the front,
uh-huh.
and I noticed it was significantly better,
mm-hmm.
but at the same, I was having actually issues with my rear shocks at the time.
Okay.
So I bought a set of MCS, and then I bought a set of 10K front springs, and then I was trying, the one thing I didn't know about the spreadsheet that I couldn't figure out was...
Uh-huh.
Which bounce ratio did I need?
Let me pause you. Let me just pause you for a sec. I just wanted to comment for anybody listening that you have an E46 M3, right? Okay, so on the spreadsheet, and I'll link to it in the description so people can reference it, the 12K front and 16K rear give about 2.6 hertz, 2.7 hertz front and 2.36, almost 2.4 hertz rear. So that's 12% pitch biased, you know, so it's definitely pitching.
Yeah.
And it's very firm. Anything over 2.2, 2.3 hertz is what I would relegate to like race car territory, like dedicated track car. I really don't recommend most people going over 2.2, 2.3 in the rear and then something softer for the front if you want a street drivable. Even if it's track, there's really no need to go that stiff. So you're already experiencing that. So I just wanted to put those numbers. And also when you went to the 10K or 9K front, right, you said that's 502 pounds per inch, and you kept the 16K rear?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's 2.33 front and 2.36 rear, so it's like 1% flat ride according to the calculator. So a little bit, but at least there's something. Okay, so please continue. Just wanted to give some numbers.
So then I decided I wanted to buy Swift springs, let's go with that.
Uh-huh.
So I decided the 9K was good, but my car was kind of low. I was rubbing up front. And so I got some 10K springs,
mm-hmm.
and I got 20K in the rear.
Mm-hmm.
And the issue, obviously, is that, like you said, it's way too stiff.
Yeah.
So that was an issue immediately.
Yeah.
And like I said, I had rear shock issues at the time, so I ended up ordering some MCS.
Okay, so let me stop the video here and I'll start another one. I just want to make sure I capture this and then let's do another part. Okay? So.
Okay.